sexy young bride. Married 3 months. Husband dies. Money gone. You claim innocence.
When we find the money, we find the killer.
Here we are in Paris after the film has finished.
Paris nurtures creativity.
And just such a privilege to be here.
The intoxication of Paris with all the energy and diversity and the exoticism. And Paris has changed so much. So I thought, let's take a fresh look in 2001.
We used to have an in-house film series where we would get together one night a week, watch a movie. Through various sources, people had been suggesting Charade. I think even before the movie was over, we were all looking at each other and going, this could be a great movie to do a new version of.
There's only one way to find out.
The film begins with the character of Regina Lambert. She is disappointed in her relationship. Her husband's away all the time.
Oh, Sylvia, what am I gonna do? How can I ever explain it to him?
And she returns to Paris to discover that...
Charles!
This is your husband.
He's dead. All the things that they owned have been liquidated into a sum of money which has disappeared.
But we do know that $6 million is a significant amount of money.
Is that what this is about?
She is one of the suspects for the murder itself. There are a whole cast of characters all after the money.
See, your husband messed us up. Something fierce.
She gets wrapped up in this terrible web of murder and suspense and romance.
Have you ever been in love in Paris, Joshua?
I can't say that I've had that pleasure.
Maybe you still have a chance.
And she needs to discover the truth about Charlie.
I was looking for a movie to do with you, Tandy, and I was particularly interested in doing something that was modern. I really wanted to find something where you could kind of be yourself and take you and put you into some hyper situation.
If you think I'm getting mixed up in this, you're absolutely bonkers.
He wanted me to basically be me in this situation and how I would feel and how I would deal.
So you gave me...
Dead husband.
A dead husband, no money.
Endless thieves trying to get something you don't have.
Dodgy boyfriend,
yes,
okay.
To say the least. But there's a lot of lines in that script that are there because it amused me to imagine you saying it.
Yeah.
I mean, like, we actually have a moment in the movie where you're telling someone who's accosting you, keep your...
I know. And but it works.
It's fun. There's certain little tics and foibles that you have as Tandy Newton that I so wanted in the movie. And if you hear something that you think is a bit fishy, exactly. I mean, you do that in real life.
Who's this guy?
He's Joshua. He's Alex.
He's
whoever we want him to be.
I've never played anybody who speaks as proper as this character does. You know, carries himself the way he does.
I really was very taken with Mark's performance in, well, Boogie Nights, and then very much so in Three Kings. This part for Mark was an enormous acting challenge, and he had to stay on top of the different personalities, and I'm so pleased with what Mark Wahlberg brought to the party.
And it's not the hip-hop street version. I'm going for something a little bit different. Definitely the unexpected.
There's a moment when the phone call comes in. You're praying that he's the good guy.
Yeah.
And yet he, at a certain point in the movie, terrifies Reggie. It would be like, run, Dandy, run! Run, Dandy!
Reggie!
He knows how to be bad,
mm-hmm.
and he knows how to be good. It's one of the things that I love about Mark's performance.
Good night, Reggie.
Nobody calls me Reggie.
Good.
Well, I think the biggest change from our script is the relationship between Tandy and Mark. They're really strongly attracted to each other.
He's a man's man, and he's the kind of guy that a woman wants to hold on to in a storm.
It's kind of a damsel in distress thing. Just click. I mean, there are the obvious reasons. I mean, she's obviously one of the most beautiful women I've ever seen in my entire life.
Did you mean what you said in the taxi?
Deeply.
That's sweet.
The combination of Mark and Tandy gave us a chance to create a really kinetic, edgy relationship. And the way they pursue this becomes a lot of fun to watch.
Am I still allowed to kiss you?
Paris is just such a visual feast with its contrasts and with its extremes.
It just seems so out of place to see these extraordinary modern skyscrapers, to see these neighborhoods.
This movie wanted to capitalize on both the classical Paris coupled with incredibly diverse, incredibly futuristic almost aspects.
Something that Hugo and I talked a lot about.
This is the art department, very important. It's kind of designed to be undesigned. The idea of it, trying to make a portrait that would kind of give Paris its own character within the film. The corridors are important in the film, to, you know, metaphor for always trying to get to something you can't quite reach. We wanted to show Reggie's confusion in the design of the film.
I really do seem to be caught up in a terrible mess.
We've tried to use a lot of glass with maps to show Reggie lost in a maze.
Jonathan wrote in the beginning of the script, it says, Paris is often wet, rainy, and gray, and that suits our needs perfectly.
The reflections and puddles in the street, you know, it's a very good effort, collaborative effort.
We had a lovely crew.
Some people were so great when we were working, too.
Because it was a French production. It's made by French filmmakers.
We were so lucky. We had 9 weeks to prep this movie, going to a foreign country where we'd never worked, which is why we wanted to work with a local crew.
It was very exciting to have some seriously engaged French film people.
It's just me, honey.
Michel Carratt, the sound man. You'd go, Michel, obviously we can't shoot now, right? It's too easy. He'd go, we try. And then he'd be there, you know, working the knob. Yeah, we resisted the impulse to educate the French and how Americans, how movies really ought to be made.
And action!
That was crap.
We put together this amazing crew so fast, and they were all fantastic, and we did. We formed a very close family.
Excuse me, have you seen Tim Robbins?
It's not here. It is gone to the park.
To the park?
Well, I'm looking for a good story. I'm looking for a part that I haven't played before.
You are with him.
Me?
He's the character, actually, I was most surprised by.
It's funny how they sometimes even seem to blend together. We didn't even bother casting Tim. We just had that part, and one day, Tim Robbins walked in.
He is Bartholomew.
Boo.
If you're not who you seem to be, the only one that should know it is really you. Well, I am Bartholomew. Well, he's very straight. Very conservative
bureaucrat, or so it seems.
Your husband occasionally lent his services to us here at the ODC.
The what?
Office of Defense Cooperation, Mrs. Lambert.
Well, I'm there to try to help Reggie. I'm trying to keep her from a criminal element.
We want that money back, Mrs. Lambert. People in that photo, they know you've got it just as surely as we do.
I've known Jonathan for 11, 12 years.
See this? It's the backup director that the Guild sent over.
He was always a very supportive, fun-loving person.
Ready, action.
Well, my first day on the film was in the Millennium Wheel.
Oh, God, the Millennium Wheel.
That was
freezing cold.
They worked with Charlie almost 3 years ago on an operation of an extraordinarily delicate nature.
I get it, and I was sort of sitting opposite Tim, watching his nose get redder and redder and redder.
Oh, boy.
Cut! First time I was in Paris was in 1968. I came over to see movies. I was living in London.
Mm-hmm.
I came over to have a weekend of Left Bank cinema.
Jonathan was, from the get-go, very interested in doing a film that we would go out on the streets and shoot the Paris that we find, and that's what we did. Jonathan quickly latched onto a very handheld visual style
We used a lot of DV footage, intercut with 16 millimeter.
We were shooting in locations where we were relying on people on the street to be the extras. They didn't know they were actually in a movie. And I know that he's been inspired by filmmakers in Paris. And it was a chance for him to play homage to them, but also use what they had introduced to film. And I love that about it, I really do.
The Truth About Charlie is more of an ensemble piece.
I mean, I know when I see the film, I remember a whole load of faces.
Instead of getting three, you know, white guys to play our three adversaries, it was fun to get Ted Levine and Lisa Gay Hamilton and Joon-hoon Park from Korea.
Bang is kind of special soldier for US government. I try my best to find the big money.
Lola Jansko is her name. She's the only woman amongst the trio. You're not quite sure if Reggie is hiding something.
That effect is a little, goes off the handle a little bit. He's kind of a burnout veteran, I guess. He just wants to get the money and go skiing. You know, and the snow's melting.
And we sort of were part of a plan to sort of take the money.
I think you have something that belongs to me.
And it sort of fell apart.
And nobody wants to offer me a more complicated explanation.
First time I read the script, my part was for a man.
As soon as we started thinking about the idea of it being a woman police inspector, the part kind of got twice as interesting.
I remember when we first met Christine. It was an interrogation.
She came in, and I said, oh, it's such an honor to meet you.
I've seen all your films. I answered him all my films. Are you sure?
I saw you in a TV series.
Where exactly was it?
There's a bunch of women around the table, and you're one of them.
I was intimidating him a little bit.
She wanted us to know how powerful she could be as a truth seeker.
And it really adds spice to it, too.
Excellent. Let's do another one right away. Hello.
Jonathan is an amazing guy.
Well, he has huge respect for the people that he joins with him to make a movie.
He always tries to find something more to help you to go further. For example, the first scene we had to do, he just asked me to look at her and to be like this.
Were you aware of his departure from France Thursday?
He helps you to define the character.
You investigate me for a while?
Yes.
Thank you.
He expects you to come prepared with everything that you want to bring to the role.
That better have been perfect, because it was perfect. It was amazing.
And all the team, too. If you look at the team, everybody is feeling the same way.
This film is in this kind of fantasy, trippy world. It's getting right inside his head, and that's a good place to be.
Okay, we can cut now. Thank you.
It's a challenge doing something different.
You want it to be different in a way that is incredibly desirable.
You know, we hope that the characters are terrific and the performances are wonderful and the story's really involving.
In a way, it's not really about the truth about Charlie. It's the truth about all of them, all the characters that get wrapped up in it. And they all learn a lot about themselves.
I really think he's going to send everybody for a loop.
And I love that. The whole idea that this is a movie, a popcorn cruncher. I love that about a picture.
Because I do this every night. It keeps my head fresh. Oh,
look at this. Watch.
Yeah, you do something amusing.
Charles Lambert's last day was busy, to us largely meaningless. 9 o'clock appointment with Dr. René. Ah! 10, simply Trocadéro. 12, 8 rue des Rosiers, Clignancourt, the flea market. 2:30, simply Aqua Boulevard.
Aqua.
Boulevard. a popular amusement center. 5:30, Old Navy, a brasserie in Saint-Germain-des-Prés. And then, nothing. Then, simply Trocadéro. Clark appointment was Dr. Henne. Boulevard, a popular amusement center. Old Navy, a brasserie in Saint-Germain-des-Prés. Huit rue des Rosiers, Clignancourt, the flea market.
What is it?
Chateau Bel Air, 95. It's the bottle from Charlie's bag.
Yeah, she left it behind at the apartment last night.
So you guys think it's poison or something?
Josephine?
Je ne sais pas, madame.
Monsieur, who sent this?
Je ne sais pas, madame.
Michelle? Lola?
Hey, Lola, hurry up! Dad's here, come on!
Let's go, sweetheart. Time to get up. Lola.
Come on, sleepyhead.
Lola.
Tim. Dial.
No. Lola, he didn't really kill Charles. He just told you that, I promise.
Dial.
Absolutely gonkers if you think for one instant that I'd even consider the non-existent possibility of sitting with that lot for even a second.
Listen to me, this is the show. You'll kill yourself one day if you don't grab it now.
Fiona, we're not here for the photo op. This is a funeral for the man I was, if only briefly and illegally, married to.
So were they, darling. It's a photo op of a lifetime.
Avec ton fils et l'esprit saint, je bénis ce corps au nom du Père et du Fils et du Saint-Esprit.
Charles? Charles! Charles!
This is your husband. I know this is difficult, but we have many questions. Is this your husband's passport? Michelle Lambert.
Yes.
And this?
No.
And this? And this?
Perhaps I will have that, Siggy.
Her husband's dead.
Sorry, our first meeting has to take place under such unhappy circumstances.
Her life is in jeopardy.
We don't know what your husband was up to, but we do know that he stole $6 million from some very lethal people.
I don't have it.
Yes, you do. You just don't know you've got it.
And there's only one person she can trust.
Joshua.
Your husband. Reggie, I'm so sorry.
I've got to get out of here. It's not just that Charles was murdered. There's all this other money, and there are other people who want it.
When we find the money, we find the killer.
Your husband messed us up something fierce. We can hurt you if we need to, badly.
Are you all right? Is that woman giving you a hard time?
Joshua!
Reggie!
Joshua!
Go!
Have you ever been in love in Paris?
I can't say that I've had that pleasure, Reggie.
Well, you're still young. Maybe you still have a chance.
Hello, Mrs. Lambert. Has he laid his little tango routine on you yet? He wants your money, and he'll do anything to get it.
Just remember, I'm on your side.
This October, one woman will discover...
I wonder what you're really like.
There's only one way to find out.
Behind every person lies a question.
Where's he going?
And behind every answer...
What's going on here?
...lies the truth.
Charles never told the truth about anything. None of you do.
The truth about Charlie.
Am I still allowed to kiss you?
Yeah.
Suspenseful masterpiece. It boasts the cream of the crop of acting talent, all at the top of their game. Red Dragon is mesmerizing from the very first frame. Brilliant. As thrilling as The Silence of the Lambs. Red Dragon, rated R.